What's the number one piece of advice you'd give to women who are considering doing more science communication?
I think people tend to underestimate their value and their wisdom because it is very intimidating. But then they should take a look at what's out there and realize that, especially if you're someone who's been working in this field for a while, you probably know quite a bit more than some of the folks who are out there talking the loudest.
I think science communication is going to become more and more important. With social media allowing us to easily and quickly disseminate information, but also misinformation, we need more and more expert voices out there. And so my suggestion would be to all people, but particularly women, to be proactive, to seek out opportunities to get training and practice in science communication. Don't be scared to reach out to a journalist or to your media communications people at your university and say, hey, this is something I'm interested in. This is my expertise.
The people who are most enthusiastic about helping, those are the people I want to hear from, the people who are offering solutions and not just identifying problems. And I find that those come from a different set of voices than we always hear from. Twitter is quite democratizing in that way, in that people decide what they're going to share and what they like to see and who they're going to follow. And if you consistently put out good content, then you're part of the conversation.
You both have your qualifications prominently in your social media. Why is that especially important to get that out there?
You know, it's sad but true. I think just being a younger woman, the default is people will take me less seriously. So it helps to put the credentials up there up front so that when people see me in a thread or my post, it's clear that I have some qualification to say what I'm saying.
Yeah, I've had experiences, and I'm sure Natalie has had experiences like this too, where I'm like walking into a seminar that I'm either about to give or, you know, I'm introducing the speaker and people have asked me, whose lab are you in? And I'm like, my lab, I'm the PI. When you're younger in your career, it does happen. And so I think establishing that credibility is important. And I wish we did not feel the need to do that. I'm not a big fan of that, but I think for women and people of color, it's important.
I think it's a real luxury to be taken seriously without putting your credentials up there. Mm-hmm. Not all of us have that luxury.
We are really enriched by hearing a diversity of voices. And I think that when we have women and people of color and people of a diversity of stages in their career, you really can get a more comprehensive picture on any topic because people are coming from their different lived experiences.